nice to have you with us today. Let me tell you something. It's Young People's Week in our show, so not only can our kids win a lot of money, but we have a wonderful holiday prize package for them. So we'll meet our card sharks in just a moment, but first let's meet the two prettiest ladies in television, holidays or not. Here they come. There are dealers on card sharks, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Welcome there, won't you please? Oh, you look so pretty today. Isn't this nice?
Yeah.
And the young ones are back, so we'll just set up the young cards. Can you do that for me? I don't know what they look like, but come on, guys. Card sharks, join us. How are you?
Fine.
Let me tell everybody at home. If you recognize these pretty faces, it's because the young kids were with us during the Thanksgiving holiday, and we had to stop right in the middle of the game. So our regular contestants will be back in a couple of weeks because we also have young people next week. And when we left off last time, our competition was between Sonny and David, and we were in game number, second game, ready to ask the first question. So that's where we are now. Sonny, tell us about yourself.
My name is Sonny Gaskalin. I'm 12 years old. I attend Malagasy Junior High School. I enjoy soccer and craft, and I have one brother.
One brother. Okay. I like it because you tell us all these wonderful things, and the last thing you say is, I have one brother. Isn't it the way? David, welcome back.
Hi, my name's David Harrison. I go to Gomper Secondary School, and I enjoy playing video games.
Gomper?
Gomper.
Where's that?
San Diego.
In San Diego. Well, okay. Now, once again, we're going to start game number two, and David won the first game, if you recall. So if David wins this game, he's the champ, goes on to play for the big money and that wonderful prize package. Sonny, if you win this game, we'll play a tiebreaker. So let's get it going right now. David, here's your question. We surveyed 100 women who have been married 50 years or more. And we asked them, was your wedding day the first time you ever kissed your husband? How many women married 50 years said their wedding day was the first time they kissed?
Oh, my grandmother's been married about 50 years, and I think that's going to be a really, really low number because my grandmother, well, she kissed him when he proposed and on some of their dates and everything, and I'm sure that most people do that, and so I'm going to say it's only about 7.
7 out of the 100, you think? So I don't really think higher or lower than that, huh?
I think it's going to be higher. I don't know anyone who's been married 50 years more, actually, but 50 years ago was in the 30s, and I think some kids probably had high school sweethearts and things, so I'm going to say higher.
Higher than the 7? Well, let's see. The actual number of women married 50 years whose wedding day was the first time they kissed their husband is 2 of them. No, it wasn't higher. It was lower. Only 2 of them. David has the control. Okay, David, you know how it works. You can change this card if you want to, so good luck to you. And here we go. David, you ready? Here it is. Jack is yours.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the jack. No. Not lower than the jack. Okay, Sonny with a free chance. Got to play this one, hon. Look at there.
Lower.
Yeah.
Lower. Yeah.
Come on. No. Oh. Woo. That's not a very good way to start, is it? Tell you what, let's do. We'll pause for these words. We'll be right back with Young People's Week on Card Sharks. See you in a moment.
Why is the whammy getting its groove on?
Snack and rock your world snack bar. Slim Fast is your life. Beat it right.
Welcome back to Card Shark Young People's Week on our show. We're having a good time with our two contestants, Sonny and David. And I tell you what, the next question, Sonny, is yours. And this question involves 10 women basketball players from Oklahoma State University. They're with us today. Well, all right, ladies. Welcome. Nice to have you here. They're going to be with us this week, all right? They're going to help us out. So, Sonny, here's a question for you involving our 10 pretty ladies down there. Before the show, we asked these 10 basketball players, would you rather be a professional basketball player or marry one? How many of these 10 women would rather be a professional basketball player?
I think they would probably want to marry one instead of be one. But I'll say that's a pretty low number, about 3.
3 of them. 3 of the 10 would rather be a professional basketball player than marry one. Let's see what David said.
Well, today with Women's Lib, that's probably why they even got into basketball. I would say that...
Now, wait a minute. What do you mean by that?
Well, I'm just saying that mainly, it used to be mainly male athletes.
Really?
And so I'm going to say it's even higher.
Even higher than that. Let's find out. Actual number of these women who would rather be a professional basketball player is 1.
Oh.
No. No. Which one of you ladies would rather be a professional basketball player? Well, Rhonda, you wouldn't want to marry one of those guys with size 15 feet. Come on.
No, I think it'd be nice to play professional basketball in Europe. That's where they women's basketball is. You can play professionally there. And then I think it'd also be hard to married professional basketball player, because it'd be hard to get a relationship going with him because he'd be on the road all the time.
You know, it'd be harder to ride on an airplane with him. They usually take up two seats and three aisles. Thank you, ladies. Nice to have you with us. It's going to be fun having you here all week. All right. Sonny, you have the control.
Lower.
We're going lower, is it?
Yeah. I'll go higher.
Higher than the sixth, the lady says. Got it?
Lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes.
Higher.
Going to go on. Sure, you can do anything you want on there. Your card. You're going to freeze right there? Okay, she's going to freeze on the seventh, so she's one card away from tying up this match. Let's see if it works. David, I got a question for you. David, we surveyed 100 single women who are in their 30s. We asked them, for $1 million, would you be willing to trade the face you have now for the face you'll have in 10 years? Got that? How many single women said for $1 million they would trade their face for the face they'll have in 10 years?
Geez, $1 million is a lot of money, and...
Certainly is.
My mother's not 30, and she's not single, but still, I think if she...
How old is she?
She's 39.
No kidding. Is she really? I didn't realize she was that old.
But I think if she had that offer, and she was single at 30, she would do it for $1 million, because marriage isn't that important, so I'm going to say that's going to be a pretty...
No, marriage is really not as important as your face, is it?
Well, I'm going to say that's going to be a pretty high number, maybe 73.
73 out of 100 single women said for $1 million they would trade their face for the face they'll have in 10 years. Sonny?
Well, I know if I was an older single woman, I would probably do it.
You mean like 39? Yeah.
I don't know, maybe not that old. I would say... I probably would change my face because I believe that, you know, a man should like you for what you are inside, not what you are outside. So I'm going to say that's even higher.
All right. Thank you. So you say it's even higher than the 73 with trades? No kidding. Of course, if you had $1 million, you could get your face back that you had at 30, couldn't you? Some people do that. Actual number of single women who would trade the face they have now for $1 million is 45.
Yeah.
Oh, only 45. I'm surprised at that. Okay, David, time for catching up. Going to keep the jack?
Yes, I'm going to lower.
And go lower it is.
Higher.
Higher than a 4, 10.
Lower.
Is it lower?
Yes. Higher.
All right, if it's higher, you're the champ. You'll play for the big money in that holiday prize package. Higher than a 5, yeah. There you go. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
You had to win after insulting your mother the way you did. Sonny, we have some wonderful prizes for
you.
Thank you very much, and have a happy holiday.
We'll see you.
Bye-bye,
okay.
Honey. Okay, David, over here. Come right over here, my friend. This is our champion. In a moment, he's going to have a chance to win a lot of money, some wonderful prizes. We'll give him that opportunity when we come back right after this. Don't go away now.
Love Connection, every night at 7:30 Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
Welcome back to Card Talk. Okay, pal, this is it. As you probably know, the Lacey and Suzanne are dealing out a deck of cards that you got earlier. And in addition to all the money you can win, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck. And anytime one of the jokers turns up, it gives you a chance of winning a fabulous holiday gift package. And Gene is going to tell you about some of the prizes you can win right now. Do you know?
Winners of today's holiday gift package will receive Magnavox Auto Eject VCR. It's cable ready with digital tuning for 100 channels, 21-day programming, on-screen display, and wireless remote from Magnavox. And the Aquafin sailboat, designed for the inexperienced sailor, easy to rig, easy to sail, and capable of carrying two adults, fun for all ages.
Whoa! Hey, and I say that's only some of the wonderful prizes that you can win. And of course, you know, because you are the champion, well, Suzanne's got two jokers for you over there, so you know you'll at least have two opportunities of winning that wonderful gift package. So we're going to start you off with $200. Before we do that, let's get Mom in here. Mom, why don't you come in here and join us? Yeah, I know you won't need much help, but she'll give you a little more support. How are you? 39 years old. He couldn't be nothing. All right, he's got the $200. Let's turn into a lot of money and win some prizes. Here we go, David. With $200, your first card happens to be a deuce. How's that? All of the money higher than the deuce. It's going to be worth $400. You got it.
$300 lower.
And keep the 10. Okay, keep the 10 and go $300 lower. Is that what you're telling me? Is it lower? Yeah. $700.
$600 higher.
$600 higher. $600 higher than the 3. 8 your card. 13.
I'm going to change that card with you.
Here, I'll give you another $400. You got $1,700. too. Oh, she smiled there. You're taking this too seriously. Get off her, Laura. Here. Okay, the eight is now a jack. And you got 1,700. $500 lower? All right. Is it lower than the jack?
No.
Back to $1,200, my friend.
$800 lower.
$800 lower. All right. Is it lower?
No.
Oh, all of it lower.
Well, just a second. We're not done yet. I got $400. Now you can bet.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than the eight, sir. It is. Now you got $800. There's the card.
Number three.
Second, let me get the eight under all the decorations. You have so much to do, though. What is the eight now? Eight is now a king.
$700 lower.
Here we go. $700 lower. All right. Is it lower than the king? Sure it is. Okay. Second to $1,500. Got $200. Now I got $1,700 in cash. Let's see Monica right over here. You do that for me? Because I want to show you something. You see here? Lacey's got seven numbered cards. Behind one of those cards is the word win. If you find that card, then you're going to win this fabulous package, including this trip for four to Hawaii. Do you know?
A trip for four. Round trip coach from Los Angeles to Honolulu from pleasant Hawaiian holidays. A fabulous week in famous Waikiki, including air transportation and luxury accommodation. Enjoy a pleasant Hawaiian vacation from pleasant Hawaiian holidays.
Okay. Now, David, Susanna's got two jokers for you. Why don't you go over there and put those jokers anywhere you want them, and let's see if you win that wonderful prize.
I'm number five and number three.
Okay, number three and number five. You come over here, stand next to Mom. Let's see if you're a big-time winner. Is it behind number three? We're looking for the word win. Is it there? Yes!
Brake levers and foam grip from Columbia Manufacturing Company. The Apple 2C is the ideal computer for the whole family. It's powerful and easy to use. Comes complete with a 2C CPU, color monitor, and stand. Yamaha Clavinova DVP3 electronic keyboard. Features piano-like keys, built-in drummer, 16 musical voices. Great for first-time musicians and seasoned players. You and your family will have hours of enjoyment with this bumper pool table from Mikhail Darabi. Featuring solid oak construction, accessories included. Plus,
with a total value of $12,531 cash and prizes for our champion, David. We'll pause and we'll be back to meet two new card sharks right after this. Don't go away now. There's so much going on in Cram that watch and play. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Wasn't that exciting? Okay, Young People's Week all week long. We're going to get two new Card Sharks in here right now. And here they come. Jamie and Jerry, please come in here. Hi. Hang on, they're applauding for you, Jamie. Now.
Hi, my name is Jamie Archner. I'm from Palos Verdes, California. I'm 11 years old. I attend Malaga Cove Junior High School, and I enjoy snow skiing and water skiing.
Oh, good. Boy, it's going to be this time of the year. You going to go skiing over the holidays?
Yeah, we just did.
Oh, wonderful. You're going to go skiing again then.
Yeah.
All right. Nice to have you. I know this guy. Hey, he's been here before. And due to a technical difficulty, we brought Jerry back. They misspelled your name, didn't they? How are you, Jerry?
Hi, my name is Jerry Daniels. I live in Kilmer Hall, Mississippi. I play football and baseball.
You play basketball?
I'm playing it now, but I like football and baseball better.
Don't tell those girls standing down there then, okay? All right. If you win two games, you're the champ. That's all you have to know. And Susanna's dealing out cards from the deck you cut earlier, so let's get it going. Jamie, the first question is yours because you won the toss of the coin. Stand with the champ, Stan. And speaking of basketball, we've got our 10 lady basketball players from Oklahoma State University. Ladies, welcome back. Now, Jamie, before the show, we asked our 10 basketball players, if you could swap your fingers, snap your fingers, yeah, swap your fingers. You tell I'm a game show host. If you could snap your fingers and be 7 feet tall, would you do it? How many of these 10 women would like to be 7 feet tall?
Well, I think that playing basketball, it's good to be tall because then you can, like, make dunk shots and all those neat shots really easily, and then you win for your team. But then, like, if you go on dates and stuff, it might be really embarrassing because then you can't really, like, kiss the guy or, like, be near the guy.
Yeah, you can sure tell if he has a bald spot, though, you know what I mean?
Right. Yeah. So, I don't think very many of them would want to be tall because, like, they don't play basketball, like, all the time. So
right.
I think the number would be about four of us.
Four out of the ten would like to be 7 feet tall if they could snap their fingers. Hey, Jerry, what do you think?
Well, if they could be 7 feet tall, they could make a lot of shots, like you said. But if they could just snap their fingers whenever they go out on a date or something. They could just snap their fingers. Whenever they go back to a game, they could turn back to 7 feet tall.
It's called Southern Logic, is what it's called. So what do you say, higher or lower than four?
I'd say higher.
Higher than that. Well, the actual number of these women who would like to be 7 feet tall is one. Only one of them. Yeah. Only one. Which one would like to be seven? Tracy, you would?
Yes.
Why, huh?
Well, I'm only 5'6", and I get knocked around by those big girls often. And I think it'd be great to be able to do a little bit of that myself.
Yeah, but you get knocked around by those big guys.
Oh, well, I wouldn't care about that.
Oh, okay. Ladies, thank you very much. Nice to have you with us. Here we go. All right. You ready, Jamie?
Yeah.
There's a card for you. 10 when a player changes.
Lower.
Gonna,
play, I'm going to play.
You're going to keep the card?
Yes.
Okay.
Lower.
Now keep the 10 and go lower than the 10. It is.
Higher.
Higher than the 3. 4.
Higher.
He's going on. Yes.
Lower.
If it's lower, you win the game, do you?
Yes, you do.
Woo. Jerry, you all right? Jerry's eyes were about that big around. He says, my gosh, what has happened to me here now? Now, Jerry, you got to win this next game and stay in this match. Jamie's won the first game and $100. How about that? Susanna's dealing out the cards. Let's get game number two going right now. Jerry, this is your question. This is an educated guess question, Jerry. You won't have much trouble with this. Look, if I stretch out my arms as far as I can, my arm span is about 6 feet, okay? Arm span 6 feet. Tell me, Jerry, how many feet is the arm span of a large gorilla?
A large gorilla sounds pretty big, and it'd probably be much larger than a man. So I'd say that'd be, how many feet?
Yeah, if I stretch out my arm span, it's about 6 feet, you know. But how many feet is the arm span of a large gorilla?
I would say about 7 feet.
7 feet. Let's see what the lady says. Jamie, higher or lower than that?
Well, I think it's higher because all the time, like, I see shows are about animals and stuff, they're always, like, going like this with them and bending them, probably because they're so long.
They're going like what, honey?
Like this.
Well, that's professional wrestling, yeah.
Yeah, so I think it's going to be higher.
All right, the arm span of the average large gorilla is 9 feet. Yes, it is higher. Jamie, you have the control. Something I learned that I didn't know, that usually your arm span, if you stretch both arms out like that, is equal to how tall you are. Did you know that? I didn't find that out until a few minutes ago when they were measuring my arm span. All right, here we go. Jamie? She's threatening on him.
No, here we go.
You ready, Jamie? There's a card for you. Queen.
Lower
than a queen. No. Oh. All right, Jerry's licking his lips. He said, come on, let's catch up. Here we go, Jerry. First card happens to be a 5. Higher than a 5. It is.
Yeah!
Lower. No.
Oh.
Woo. Goodness. All right. We're back to the old base cards then. We'll come back to find out who our champion's going to be right after this. Don't go away, okay?
To play Lingo, just think of the opponent as the...
Welcome back to Car Shows. Boy, we have an exciting day today. The young people are going to be with us all week long. We always look forward to getting their attitudes about life and such, and also winning these nice prizes, too. So Jamie and Jerry are going to be back with us next time. We certainly hope you will be, too. For Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Gene Wood, and the whole gang, Gene, welcome back. And I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time on Card Charge. Bye-bye, everybody.
Go, Scott, kind whammy,
old. Then line up for laughs with your favorite celebrities on Hollywood Squares and Match Games. Need to lose those extra pounds? Let Cram and Game Show Network show you how. Tighten those muscles as you walk on hamster wheels. Sweat away those love handles playing hockey with cheese. Pedal bikes as your partner answers ridiculous riddles. And melt those inches off your waist.